Hello guys, welcome to the chapter 1 of real-time hair creation course, which is Blockout Hairstyle in ZBrush. I hope you have gone through my first introductory video of real-time hair. If not, please go through it. So let's start with blockout of our hairstyle in ZBrush. I would say this is one of the most important part of hair creation. So it starts from finding a good reference. So I'm showing you some kind of good website, or you can go to a Google image. So find good 10 to 15 reference from each angle. This is super important. And another best site to collect reference is ArtStation itself, because here you can see the other artist's best results, and it also help you to understand the industrial standards, and you use other artists' tips and tricks to create a difficult or complex model. So in this blockout chapter, I will introduce you to the ZBrush tools, some important brushes like curve tool, clay buildup, dance standard, and I will show you how to make these hair braid and so many more things. So for that, just subscribe this channel. This is very important because you are going to get a lot of things. So the most important things in blockouts are to maintain volume, direction of hair flow, and our hairline. So you should check all these things in different angle of model using your reference images. If you want to hairstyle look natural, make sure the hairline should be exact as the reference. So you have to take care about the angle, area, or outline of a hairline. Those should be matched with the reference anatomy with special pattern of hair grooming. Now create our mesh blockout in ZBrush. So first, let's start with hairline. I'm using RGB brush to draw my hairline, and for that I just turn off ZZ and turn on RGB, and I'm selecting my black color. Now I'm going to paint like a paintbrush on my model. Here you can see female hairline has a curves. It has very smooth finishing, and whereas other side male has sharp edges. So now let's talk about curved tube brush. So it is very useful to create clumps. So go for press B and B for brush. Here you have a curve tube. Now make sure you don't have any subdivision in your mesh. Just draw the curve. You can see I can change the size of this tube by just decreasing your brush size. So you can move anywhere and adjust it accordingly. Now here in stock menu, there are so many options related to curves, like curve function, curve modifier and all. So by using this, you can modify your tube curve accordingly. So here you can see there is an option called lock starting. So with the help of this, you can lock your starting point. So here you can see my starting pinpoint is locked, and now I am moving my tube anywhere, but starting point is fixed. Now there are so many other options. Here we have a curve modifier. So if I want to change the size of a tube in a specific manner, or a increasing or decreasing manner, so you can adjust by this fall off curve. You can see I am adjusting this curve from high to low. So now I'm clicking on size. Now I'm clicking on tube. Now you can see I have created this specific shape of my tube by using curve modifier. There are so many options, you can also check out by your own. Now moving on, let's take a look on a hair braid creation in ZBrush. I'm going to create this hair braid by using Z-Spear. I have created a separate video on Z-Spear only. You can check out and learn how to handle with Z-Spear. This is very important and useful tool to create any blockout in ZBrush. Now for now, just mind these basic hotkey for Z-Spear. Q to draw a Z-Spear, W to move, E for scale, R for rotate. Now I'm going to in a front view and arranging these spear in such a way that I'm creating a straight line like this. So I'm going to draw some extra spear in between. Now I'm moving these two spear in either sides like this. So I'm going to do this to make a 3D spiral kind of structure. Now go to the top view and it's look like a diamond shape like this, or like a infinity symbols you can see here. Now on the top view, just add more Z spear on the edges to make a smooth curve. You can easily preview your blockout mesh by just pressing A. It is very important to know how your mesh going. Now you can check your mesh by pressing A. Just press A key and you can preview your mesh. So when your preview mesh is good, then go to adaptive skin option and make adaptive skin. Now we have a separate subtool for my preview mesh. Now you can work on this adaptive skin mesh. Now you can work on this editable mesh. So now just duplicate and move up over here and connect these kind of spiral kind of structure. Now again, just duplicate multiple times. Now go to subtools and merge them all. Now I'm going to press Dynamesh. Now go to Remesh to give a good topology. Now go to deformation and polish these edges to give a specific smooth curves. Now again, duplicate these kind of spirals and move a little bit up. So I'm going to duplicate this 3 times and set these in a equal space. Now just scale and give some inflate deformation to connect to each other. So now you can see with us scaling and adjusting this width of braid, my hair braid is ready. Now go to my original model and append this hair braid on my model. So this is very useful to create a quick sharp hair braid here. So now this is all about blocking out your hairstyle. So this is important features to understand or to know about how to hair works in as in blockout. So this is just a blockout. In the next coming video, I'm going to share with you a specific hair creation using Xen in Maya. For that, you have to subscribe this channel because there are a lot of things you are going to get in. So for now, just enjoy this time lapse.
Times like all you want to do is run. new.